We discussed division algorithm yesterday, right? And we have to do exercise 2.3. The very first question where you just have to carry out division and obtain the quotient and remainder. Let's begin with this. And side by side, we will be revising how we carry out the division in case you've forgotten. So I'll just directly start with first part. You're given polynomials Px and Gx. Check that the terms should be in the order where the power of the variable is decreasing. So that's most important, that the power of the variable in the term should be in decreasing order. Other than that, if there is any term which is missing, you could write that down as zero times the variable if you want, or you can do it completely without mentioning that term. It depends on your personal preference. So this one is your dividend, Px. X square minus 2 is your divisor. Obtaining the terms of the quotient one by one. You can do this in your working column if you want. So we look at the first term and divide it by the first term of our divisor. So first term from your dividend divided by your first term of the divisor, whatever is left will be your first term of the quotient. So X is your first term of the quotient. Then you need to multiply your divisor with this. एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस टू इस बाइनोमियल को आपको एक्स से मल्टीप्लाई करना है. दिस इज व्हाट यू गेट. यू वांट टू राइट दिस डाउन बिलो योर डिविडेंड, अरेंजिंग द टर्म्स इन लाइक कॉलम्स. सो एक्स क्यूब विल बी इन द कॉलम सेम एज एक्स क्यूब माइनस टू एक्स. यहाँ पे x की पावर 1 है तो इसको उस कॉलम में लिखना जहां पे x की पावर 1 हो. माइनस टू एक्स विल बी रिटन बिलो 5x. हमारे पास स्क्वायर वाली टर्म नहीं है तो हम स्क्वायर वाली टर्म के नीचे कुछ नहीं लिख रहे. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू चेंज द साइंस बिकॉज इट्स सब्ट्रैक्शन. आपको सब्ट्रैक्ट करना है. सो चेंजिंग द साइंस ऑफ दीज टर्म्स, दिस बिकम्स नेगेटिव. नेगेटिव टू एक्स बिकम्स पॉजिटिव. Now carry out the simplification. X cube minus x cube, they get cancelled. From here, you get 7x with a plus sign. The rest of the terms can be just noted down as it is. Now for the next term of your quotient. अब आपको नेक्स्ट टर्म ऑब्टेन करनी है. वी विल टेक द फर्स्ट टर्म ऑफ दिस रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द डिविडेंड, व्हाटएवर इज लेफ्ट ऑफ द डिविडेंड. वी विल टेक द फर्स्ट टर्म माइनस 3x स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय द फर्स्ट टर्म. हियर फर्स्ट फर्स्ट टर्म को डिवाइड करके व्हाटएवर इज लेफ्ट विल बी योर पार्ट ऑफ द क्वोशंट. The next step is to multiply your divisor with minus 3. So divisor is x square minus 2, multiplying it with 3. Writing it down here, it's minus 3. 6 will be written in the column where you've written your constant. Change the signs, simplify. Minus 3x square plus 3x square, they get cancelled. Minus 3 minus 6 makes minus 9, and this term is left here. This is where you stop. This is the remainder, and you always check that the remainder that you have obtained should either be 0. If it's 0, then completely fine. You don't have to worry about it. If it is a polynomial, तो जो डिग्री है रिमाइंडर की वो आपके डिवाइजर की डिग्री से कम होनी चाहिए. तो आपका यहाँ पे जो रिमाइंडर आया है आर एक्स, इसकी डिग्री है 1. दिस इज अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल. इट शुड बी स्मॉलर दैन द डिग्री ऑफ योर डिवाइजर. इसकी डिग्री आपके पास 2 है और रिमाइंडर की डिग्री 1 है. इक्वल भी नहीं चाहिए आपको, अगर इक्वल भी है दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू डू वन मोर स्टेप, कम होनी चाहिए. You can give your answer. The quotient Qx is x minus 3. The remainder Rx is 7x minus 9. Anyone with questions regarding how to carry out the division?
No, ma'am.
There is one example, I think, in your textbook which says you have to carry out the division and then verify the division algorithm. So that would be like checking your division. It's example number 8. Agar aapko bol rahe hain ki division algorithm verify karo, that means aapko apni division check karni hai. So the relation that you used in your junior classes, this is what you will be applying here. And see if you multiply your divisor with your quotient, add the remainder, you should obtain the dividend. The left hand side should be equal to right hand side. This is what you want to do if you are asked to verify the division algorithm. Second part, Px is given as x to the power 4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5. The divisor is x square plus 1 minus x. So the first one is okay. If you want, you can write it like this. The term with x cube is not there. You can write that. The rest of the terms are in order. So we are okay with it. Whereas gx, this needs to be fixed. Before you carry out your division, this will be x square minus x plus 1. And then you can carry out your division. Last year, the questions that you did, division was with binomials mostly. Most of the question had division with the binomial. This one is a trinomial, so do it carefully. Teen terms aayengi aapki har baar. Jab aap carry out karoge multiplication, be careful. So I'm again using my working column to obtain the quotient. The first term, x to the power 4, divided by first term from my divisor, will give me the first term of the quotient. Now your divisor is to be multiplied with x square. So x square minus x plus 1 multiplied with this term we obtained. Writing it below your dividend, like terms should fall below each other. They should be in the same column. X raised to the power 4. Then we have a cubic term. I have written it as 0x cube. Agar ye aapne nahi likha hota, if you had not written this, तो फिर ये क्यूबिक टर्म आप लास्ट में भी लिख सकते हो. यू कैन राइट माइनस एक्स क्यूब एट द एंड बिकॉज यू डिड नॉट मेंशन अ टर्म कंटेनिंग एक्स क्यूब. सो यू कुड हैव जस्ट रिटन इट एट द एंड. राइट नाउ व्हाट आई हैव डन इज आई हैव रिटन एंड यू कैन सी दैट एक्चुअली हेल्प्स यू. माइनस एक्स क्यूब, देन योर स्क्वायर टर्म. Changing the signs. Simplify. This is 0 plus 1. Minus 3 minus 1. Rest of the terms as it is. What will be the next term in your quotient?
Positive x.
Positive x. Now, if you are okay, you can work out directly. अगर आपको practice है, तो आपको ये working column वाला काम करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. आप directly वहाँ पे term लिख सकते हो और अपने divisor को उससे multiply करके whatever you have the expression can be arranged below your dividend. So I'm going to use this here for a couple of parts, then I will switch to doing it directly. So divisor multiplied with this x, you get x cube minus x square plus x. Arrange it below your dividend. x cube minus x square plus x. The next step is to change the signs. This becomes negative, positive, negative. The terms containing x cube, they are cancelled. You are left with minus 3x square plus 3x plus 5. Obtain the next term. So take the first term minus 3x square and the first term from your divisor.
Minus 3.
You get minus 3. Don't forget to write this here. Ye bhool jate hain students likhna. Division karte jata hai, ye likhna bhool jate hain. So minus 3 is the term for this step in your quotient. You multiply your divisor with your term you obtained and write down here minus 3x square. Plus 3x minus 3. Then change the signs and simplify. So remainder is a constant polynomial. The degree for this will be?
Please wait.
Zero. One.
Zero.
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 Yes. For a constant non-zero polynomial. Agar aapke paas constant polynomial hai, the constant is non-zero, then the degree is zero. But if you have a zero polynomial,
not defined.
The degree is not defined. Those who have done can carry out the division for third part. Rearrange your terms for your divisor. For your dividend, you want to write down the terms with cube and square. Two terms missing hai. पावर फोर के बाद सीधा पावर वन आ रही है. क्यूबिक टर्म नहीं है, स्क्वायर टर्म नहीं है. अर्शप्रीत इतना डन?
यस मैम.
You have your dividend as x raised to the power 4 minus 5x plus 6 and the divisor is 2 minus x squared. So we are arranging them in standard form. For this one, you'll have minus x squared plus 2. First term of the quotient.
X
minus x square.
Yes, minus,
minus x square. X square. Multiply your divisor with the term you obtained. Change the signs and simplify. Now, this term here is zero. You can completely ignore it or you can write down if you want. So as it is, 2x square minus 5x as it is, plus 6 as it is. Next term of your quotient.
Minus 2.
You can completely ignore this because you don't have a term containing cube, so you don't have to worry about that. Ye to already eliminated hai. Purpose hamara ye hota hai, hum one by one terms eliminate karte hain. X raised to the power 4, that term has been eliminated. X cube, wo term already expression mein missing hai, to uske baare mein aapko sochne ki zarurat nahi hai. If you would do, you will write it as 0 times x. You don't have to do that. So focus on eliminating the term containing x square. So this can be ignored if you want, right? Just completely ignore it. It's already zero. Focus on eliminating 2x square. So 2x square divided. This will give you minus 2. Minus 2 in your quotient. Multiply the divisor with minus 2. Minus x square plus 2 multiplied with minus 2. Changing the signs and simplifying. Check the degree of your remainder, whatever you're left with. Terms are used ho chuki hain aapke dividend ki at this step. Check the degree of your remainder should be smaller than the degree of your divisor. And then you can give your answer. Any student who still has trouble recalling how to carry out the division? All right. Question number 2. Again, you have to carry out the division and check whether the divisor is a factor of the dividend. So we are looking for the remainder to be 0. We will carry out the division. If the remainder is 0, the answer will be yes. If the remainder is not 0, then the answer will be no. Question number 2. First part, let's go back to the textbook. Okay, so be a little careful. First one ko check karna hai ki wo factor hai ya nahi. So the first polynomial will be your divisor. The second one is your dividend. So you can represent them accordingly. Dividend can be represented by px. Divisor can be represented by gx. It's completely fine if you don't want to do the representation. You can directly write down those division thing. Aap seedha carry out kar sakte ho bina unko represent kiye. For the first part, the polynomial is in t. I had written px and gx there. The polynomial is in t. So represent accordingly if you are doing it. Now carry out the division. If you want to make use of your working column to obtain the term of the quotient and then multiply to obtain whatever is to be written here, do that way, or you can do it directly the way I'm doing. But before you do it directly, make sure you have enough practice. So term containing t to the power 4 is cancelled. You're left with 3t cube plus 4t square minus 9t minus 12. The next term for the quotient,
Plus 3t
multiplying our divisor with plus 3t. Changing the signs. Term containing t cube is cancelled. Term containing t is also cancelled. We are left with 4t square minus 12. So t square to be converted into 4t square plus 4. Changing the signs, both terms are cancelled. The remainder is 0. Is it done?
Yes, ma'am.
Your polynomials are already arranged in standard form. Okay, what will be the first term here for the quotient?
3x squared.
3x squared.
And after multiplying 3x squared with the divisor, you obtain 3x raised to the power 4
plus 9x cube minus 3, plus 3x squared.
Change the signs and simplify. The first term eliminated. You're left with minus 4x cube minus 10x squared plus 2x plus 2 as it is. Next term.
Minus 4x.
Minus 4x.
Multiply. Change the signs. You're left with 2x squared plus 6x plus 2. Next term.
Plus 2.
Plus 2.
Plus 2.
2x squared plus 6x plus 2. As you can see, we get the exact same expression.
0. Remainder is 0.
Remainder is 0.
Gx is
a
factor of
Px. You can write down Gx is a factor of Px. Anyone who's writing down?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, please wait.
Sure.
Yes, ma'am, done.
Expressing the dividend in standard form. One term is missing. Again, it's personal preference if you can carry out your division directly by using these as such without writing down the missing term. You can do that. For the divisor, I usually don't prefer writing down the missing terms. For the dividend, I prefer writing down the missing term because in case division karte time, mere paas x to the power 4 wali term aaye, to main usko kis column mein likhungi? Just keeping that in mind. Thinking of it in advance. Ho sakta hai zarurat na bhi pade. My divisor. The first term for the quotient will be x square. Change the signs. Simplify. This term is already zero. So if you want, you can write this or ignore it. Then we have minus 1 x cubed. These are cancelled.
Minus one.
The remainder is two. It is not a factor of px.
The remainder is not zero. So gx is not a factor of px. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Before we do question number 3, we are going to do example number 9. The questions are similar. So I would like to discuss example number 9 first. Page 35. Find all zeros of the given polynomial if you know that two of its zeros are under root 2 and minus under root 2. This is an important type that you are given a polynomial or uski aapko ek zero di hai ya do zeros di hui hai aur aapko remaining zeros find out karni hai. This question usually is related to a cubic polynomial or of higher degree. Quadratic pe nahi aata ye. Quadratic mein agar aapko ek zero denge aap dusri quickly find out kar sakte ho. But for cubic and of higher degree, the polynomials with higher degrees, you could have questions like these. Cubic or power 4, biquadratic or cubic zyada aate hain. So we are given this polynomial. We will represent it as px. इसके आपको दो जीरोस दिए हुए हैं. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज जीरोस गिवन टू अस वी कैन ऑब्टेन टू फैक्टर्स. सिंस द जीरोस आर डिस्टिंक्ट दोज फैक्टर्स विल ऑल्सो बी डिस्टिंक्ट फैक्टर्स. आपके पास रूट टू इज अ जीरो. दिस इंप्लाइज x minus root 2 is a factor. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Similarly, if minus root 2 is a 0, from here, the factor is
x plus root 2 is factor.
And we have now two distinct factors. Aapke paas do distinct factors mil gaye aapko px ke. एक आपको ये मिला पहली जीरो से और एक आपको ये मिला. इफ यू हैव टू डिस्टिंक्ट जीरोस ऑफ अ पॉलिनोमियल देयर प्रोडक्ट इज आल्सो अ जीरो ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉलिनोमियल. सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच आई वुड लाइक यू टू राइट एज अ नोट वंस वी स्टार्ट राइटिंग कि अगर आपके पास किसी भी पॉलिनोमियल के दो डिस्टिंक्ट जीरोस हैं, इफ एक्स माइनस ए एक्स माइनस बी आर टू सॉरी factors, if we have x minus a, x minus b, two distinct factors of a polynomial px, then the product of these two is also a factor of px. So, हमारे पास इंडिविजुअल दो फैक्टर्स हैं, दोनों डिस्टिंक्ट हैं. यहां से हम ये कंक्लूड करेंगे कि जो इनका प्रोडक्ट होगा वो भी पी एक्स का फैक्टर होगा. When you multiply these two linear factors, you actually get a quadratic factor. यहां से आपके पास ये जो प्रोडक्ट है, this product on simplification gives you x square minus 2, a factor of px. Let me know if you're clear what we've done so far.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
इसके बाद आपका जो वर्क होगा वो बिल्कुल सिमिलर होगा जैसे आप क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल की फैक्टराइजेशन करते थे. जीरो की हेल्प से फैक्टर ऑब्टेन करते थे, फिर डिविजन करते थे. डिविजन करने के बाद जो क्वोशंट आता है आप उसको फर्दर फैक्टराइज करते हो एंड यू हैव योर क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल फैक्टराइज्ड इनटू लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल्स और लीनियर फैक्टर्स. नाउ एट दिस पॉइंट फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन हमारे पास क्योंकि दो जीरोस थी, उन दो जीरो से हमें दो फैक्टर्स मिले. उन दो फैक्टर्स को अगर आप कंबाइन करते हो आपको एक क्वाड्रेटिक फैक्टर मिलेगा. उस क्वाड्रेटिक फैक्टर से हम डिविजन करेंगे. So the next step will be to divide px by this factor we obtained. Is division ke baad jo quotient aayega, remainder will definitely be zero kyunki hum yahan pe bol rahe hain ki x square minus 2 factor hai. To remainder zero aayega. Jo bhi aapke paas quotient aayega, aap usko further factorize karoge to obtain the remaining factors of px. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And
yes,
once ma'am. You have factorized the quotient, usme se jo bhi aapko linear factors milenge, wahan se aap zeros obtain kar sakte hain. Let's do it. We will write it down and side by side revise. if you follow the method which you used to follow to factorize a cubic polynomial, आप एग्जैक्टली वो चीज भी कर सकते हो अगर आपको कोई भी जीरो नहीं दी हुई. यू स्टार्ट विद योर कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म, आप उसके फैक्टर्स लिखते हो, ट्रायल एंड एरर से आप जो फैक्टर्स हैं ट्राई करते हो उनमें से कोई जीरो मिल जाए आपको. वंस यू ऑब्टेन वन जीरो उससे हम फैक्टर बनाते हैं, फिर डिविजन करते हैं. जो क्वेश्चन आता है उसको आप फर्दर फैक्टराइज करोगे. इस केस में आपको वो दो बार करना पड़ेगा. सिंगल जीरो ऑब्टेन होगी, उसके बाद सिंगल फैक्टर मिलेगा, लीनियर फैक्टर. उससे जब आप डिवाइड करोगे द क्वेश्चन विल बी अ क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल. अब क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल की फैक्टराइजेशन करने के लिए फिर से वही सारे स्टेप्स आपको रिपीट करने पड़ेंगे. स्टार्टिंग विद द कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म, उसके आपने फैक्टर्स लिखे, उनमें से कोई जीरो ढूंढी, फिर आपको उससे फैक्टर मिलेगा, फिर क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल को डिवाइड करोगे, देन यू रीच अ क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल एज योर क्वेश्चन. And then you factorize it further by using splitting the middle term or any identity and obtain the rest of the factors. Here as a hint or as your help, दो zeros उन्होंने directly आपको दे दी, उससे आपको दो factors मिल रहे हैं. उन दो factors को combine करके हमें quadratic factor मिल रहा है. We will carry out the division of the polynomial with that quadratic factor. And whatever is the quotient, that will be factorized further to obtain the remaining factors. And hence obtain the remaining zeros. So the next step is to carry out the division of Px by this quadratic factor. We'll be doing it the next time. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. God bless you all.